Hi guys, this is Avinash Sharma, and in this session we will see how to create the temporary table in SQL Server. What are the temporary tables? These tables stay in the SQL Server for the temporary purpose. Say if you create the table for a collection or for a session, so till that collection or session is alive, your table is there. Once your collection is closed or your session is stopped, those temporary table automatically is dropped, and these tables are created in the TempDB database. And these tables, temporary tables, are like a normal table. It means you can apply the select, delete or insert statement. And if you are using the temporary table inside the procedure, so on the completion of the procedure, those temporary table automatically drop. Now, types of temporary table in SQL Server. There are two types, local and global. Both are created in the TempDB, but in case of the local, if you create the local temporary table, so that table is accessibility is available only that connection in which that table has been created. Once you close that collection or session, that table is automatically dropped. But in case of the global temporary table, once you create the global temporary table, so that table is available in all connections and all sessions, and that table remains in the existence till all connections and sessions are alive. Once you close all connection and sessions, that global table is automatically dropped. When to use the SQL temp tables? Suppose you want faster manipulation in some table, then you can use the temporary table because the manipulation is faster than the permanent table. Secondly, if you want to create a table in database and you don't have write, in that case you create the temporary table, read the data and fill the temporary table, then manipulate the table with the DDL or DML statement. And finally, suppose you have done some calculation and you do not want the data to be shared by the other users. In that case, you can use the temporary table for that session. Now we will check on the SQL Server how to create the temporary local table and how to create the temporary global table. Now, the first tool is prefix the hashtag in temp table, or it is created in the TempDB, okay, and can be created with the select statement or create statement. It means we have two methods. We can create the temporary table with the select or create statement. So we will check both. First of all, we check the select statement. So select, we have this table, we check the data for this table. So roll number, science, math, marks. Now we will put these data in a temporary table. How? Say select into then temporary table name, say local temp from student marks. So this is the statement, select star into, then this is the name of the local table name. We have a prefix as a hashtag, name of the local temp and from this table. So what we are doing, we are copying the data from student marks table to the our local temporary table. So first of all, we check the TempDB system database. We have TempDT, and second option is the temporary table. I refresh that one. Now you can see it's a local temp. So this is the table, local temporary table created in the TempDB database. Now I check the data in local temp table. So you can see we have the same data as we had in the student marks table because we copied all data. And if you change anything in the local temporary table, so there is no impact on the original table. See how. Suppose roll number equal to 1 and you delete this one, check the temp table. So roll number 1 gone. And if you check the original table, that is the student marks, so roll number 1 is there. It means anything change in the temporary table, there is no impact on the original table. Now the limitation with the local table is it can be accessed only with that connection or session in which this has been created. So if I try to access this table in another connection, say how I try this statement and new query, so basically I am creating a new session or new connection. If I try this statement here, then say execute, I get the error invalid object name, because this is a local table and cannot be accessed in any other connection or session. Okay. Now, how to drop this table? You can use the manual statement, say as you do in the normal case, normal table. So you can drop the temp table in same way. Or secondly, if you close this connection or session, currently this is the session or collection, so I have created this table in this connection. If I close this one, so this table is automatically deleted or dropped from this temporary tables. I refresh this one, it is still there. Now I close this session. Now I refresh this again, so you can see that table, temporary table, gone. Now we will try this time create table. Means we'll create the temporary table with the create statement. We have the create table, then hashtag, and this is the name of the table, and roll number, then city. So I create this table. Okay. I check temporary table, then temporary table is temp student, is created here. Now I try this statement. Now check data in temp table. Okay. So we have the value, we have the record for this temporary table. Now how to drop this table? We will use the statement. Now so table gone. So this way you can use the create table statement for creating the local temporary table. Again check in the this one, table gone from here. Now we'll see how to create the temporary global table. So as you can see in the definition, this time we have two hashtag, double hashtag. This is the name of the table. I create this table and so this table is created again temp db database. Refresh this one and you can see table is here. Now I'm inserting these three records in this temporary table. Execute. Now check the data. Okay, we have three records. And I open a new connection or new session, new query, and check here. So check here. Okay. It means we can access this global table. New connection again. Execute. It means this global table can be accessed in any connection or any session. This is a temporary table. But what is the life cycle of this global temporary table? This temporary global table is alive till the all connection or all session who is referring this table is alive. Once you close all session or connection, the table is deleted automatically from the database. See how we have three connections, 1, 2, 3. So first of all I close this one and check. So refresh, the table is there. I close second connection, again refresh, table is there. Finally, we have only one connection. I close this connection. Now, again check. Table gone. So this is the difference between the local and global temporary table. So guys, this was all about the temporary tables in the SQL Server. I hope you understood everything. Thanks for watching the video.